Senior House officers will also double as qualified medical officers who are training to become specialists, laid down tools since first of this month, but continue to provide emergency services to the critically ill patients in government hospitals.
Is how many government officials can go 1 or 2 months without pay? We have several senior house officers, these are specialists in training, who are dropping out of school. Their children are at home. They cannot afford a meal. They cannot pay rent. Many are sleeping in classrooms, while people sit in their SC offices.
These have, however, threatened to withdraw emergency services until their allowance arrears are cleared.
As our supervisors are leaving their stations, the senior house officers and clinical fellows nationwide are going to leave all stations, and we shall not cover any emergencies with immediate from today at 11 p.m.
The associate consultants have also joined the strike. They are demanding that government increases their allowances from 6 to 11 million and their name be changed from medical officers, special grade, to associate consultants.
We had agreed that the salary of medical officer special grade be at least 11 million, but we have been trekking up and forth. We don't know why we are still being given 6 million, and that we are a very crucial cadre. We are the doctors who are providing surgery, as surgeons, we are the ones who are looking after the children, the neonates, as pediatricians. We are the ones who are operating the obstetricians. It's our level. We are being prevented, you know, from getting promotion. So we are saying these two issues must be addressed. We must be called, and we have requested to have a meeting with His Excellency the President. But up to now, we have not been able to meet the President.
So we are calling on government to consider this, to consider accelerated promotions, because people are suffering. They cannot bargain even when opportunities come out there for jobs, even out of government. They cannot go and state that, okay, I have this qualification because we have failed to be promoted. So we pray that they will answer this call. And if they don't, for us, we are deciding to stay away from work until they sort these matters as urgently, as quickly as possible.
In response, the government has advised the aggrieved medical team to resort to meaningful engagements with the concerned authorities. The minister added that such strikes are uncalled for since government increased salaries for scientists, including doctors and health workers.
Uganda Medical Association is laying down their tools because they expected a pay increase be announced from cabinet. But we have just enhanced the salaries of doctors and health workers and scientists. So why are they, maybe it's not you actually representing what they are saying. We have just raised the salaries of scientists, including doctors and health workers. So the issue of salary enhancement, we don't expect it to be a concern now from the doctors.
He, however, noted that the Minister of Health has drafted the internship policy, which helps in guiding the deployment of the growing number of intern doctors in the country.
Strikes and demonstrations may not be the solution, but constructive engagement can always enable free flow of information, and then we move together.
Strikes by government health workers leave hundreds of patients, including those with life-threatening conditions, at God's mercy, with many left stranded and deserted at government health facilities across the country. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.